Welcome back to watching the newsroom right here on ET Now. And let's tilt the focus and talk about markets. Sampath Reddy is joining us now. Sampath, how are you analyzing the market right now? It seemed to be climbing the wall of worry. What are your thoughts on the valuations versus the earnings narrative and the capex cycle narrative which is on the table now?
Yeah, hi Ajay. Yeah, that is true. Actually, market, in spite of the the second wave of pandemic, markets continue to do very well. If you recall, overall in the last 1.5 years, in spite of this severe lockdown that we had seen in the whole of the last financial year, corporate earnings have actually surprised a lot. Most of the analysts and market participants were believing that FY21 probably will see an earnings decline because of the lockdown. But contrary to the many expectations, earnings have actually grown quite substantially well. FY21, I guess, earnings are growing in the range of anywhere between 15 to 20%. That was a big surprise factor. And not only that, in FY22 also, the earnings growth expectation continues to be quite strong. This was a little bit of a surprise to the market, and that's where, I think this is one of the reasons behind the strong rally. That's one. And not only that, the expectations, almost all, investors have seen how it has how the market has panned out after the sell-off during the last March April lockdown. Any such kind of an event which were to be there, most of the investors are actually looking to buy into the dips rather than, worried about the near-term impacts of the lockdown. I think these two behavioral change about the, about behavioral change regarding how it has seen in the last, first wave of the pandemic versus and also the, the surprise element in the corporate earnings taking together is ensuring that markets, actually climbing high every day. Just on the valuation side, most parameters, if one were to look at it, whether it's a market cap to GDP or, price to book, even the P earnings wise also, market valuations are slightly, I would think, the closer to the upper end of the band. So in that sense, markets are, I would say, pricing for pretty much like perfection, and if there is any unforeseen event that will be there, or in any shocks were there will be externally, I think we could see a correction if our other markets are not factoring in that kind of volatility at this juncture.
Right. Sambhat, what are your thoughts on how the phase of the rally? You've been around long enough, you've seen several boom and busts and phases of the economy right now. Where is the market right now? If you look at, if you superimpose the market on top of the economic cycle and phase of the cycle.
Right. As I was mentioning, there are two things. One is the economic cycle was not really doing that well. We've been keep hearing that, the bottom end of the pyramid is suffering a lot. There are job losses. And obviously, there's an income losses to the many segments because of this, lockdown. But in spite of that, what is surprising is that corporate profits have done very well. Some of that is because of, the cost cutting. And that was one of the reasons, but also, because of the very soft commodity prices or, input prices, I would say, overall the margins have seen, quite well, for the last financial year. I think some of that maybe, have to be, give up in the FY22. Some, because we are already seeing the input prices moving up, like, aluminum, steel prices have already started going up. And so as the case with many of the agri commodity prices have also started moving up. So some of these input price rise would have some impact on the margins going forward, in spite of pretty much near zero GDP growth for the last 2 years, let's say 7.5% decline in the last year, and about 9 to 10% growth in the FY22, taking together the GDP will be plus or minus about 1% kind of a growth. Of course, even if you add the nominal GDP along to that, overall, last 2 years have been a very poor economic growth. But in spite of that, if you look at FY 21 and 22 earnings growth of the corporate sector, you know, there would be, you know, very, very high. I mean, probably both the years taken together, earnings would have, you know, grown at a compounded pace of almost about 20-25% range. So that was a big surprise part. You know, basically the margins have expanded quite well. We have to see whether that is really sustainable or not. I think that is what is actually, you know, ensuring the rally to continue. Bigger worries than for me in terms of market is that, you know, when the interest rates will move, to some extent the market rally was also driven by the PE expansion. The way the valuation which are trading today upwards of 20-21 times even FY23 earnings, you know, seems to be slightly on the higher side of it. But all of that is justified, you know, as long as the interest rate were going down and interest rates were very low. But if the, you know, interest rates were to move up from here on, you know, how will the, you know, the multiples will move? You know, that will be a really challenging part. If you look at the overall, you know, why we are worried about the interest rates, you know, overall, if you look at the Fed action or even the global central bankers or even, you know, RBI in India, over the last 1.5 years, they have infused a tremendous amount of liquidity, and all of that has helped, you know, to, you know, cope with the kind of a lockdown that most countries have witnessed. But now, you know, with the commodity prices going up, with the, you know, crude prices going up, I think slowly the inflation will start, you know, showing up, and that's when the, you know, interest rate, you know, some of these excess liquidity will be taken away and the interest rates will be moving up. During that scenario, how will the, you know, PE multiple will behave is a little bit of a, you know, worrisome at this juncture.
Sure. Sambhat, how have you structured your portfolios right now? Yours is typically long-term money, and you're not, you know, dependent on quarter-to-quarter or month-on-month movement of the market as such. Your bets can be deep-rooted. How are you structuring the portfolio to, you know, take advantage of the way cycle may pan out next few years?
So we have been liking the IT and pharmaceutical sectors for quite some time, and we continue to like that. And over and above, you know, we have been tilting more towards, you know, export-oriented companies. If you look at the, you know, overall the vaccination, you know, program, you know, most of the developed countries are, you know, way ahead in terms of, you know, vaccination, and relatively they were less affected because of the second wave. I think the developed economy is pretty much very close to opening up, or rather, you know, very close to the, you know, the pre-COVID levels. Because of that, I think, you know, we could see a good demand from the export-oriented companies, the export-oriented products and services. So we've been liking the IT pharma. Apart from that, you know, any of the you know, manufacturing export-oriented companies also, we've been preferring that. Within the, you know, financials, also again, we've been liking the, you know, the top few banks or top few private sector banks. You know, in spite of the kind of slowdown that has been there, the asset quality has been maintained very well by these banks. These are the segments, you know, we've been continuing to be positive and continue to be overweight.
Right. And what's your positioning in the broader market? Because there seem to be the bigger rally and the bigger moves which are playing, reminding people of 2015-16 kind of time. 17 onwards, of course, most were beaten out of shape only to come back a couple of months back. What are your thoughts on standing on mid-cap end of the basket?
Right. I think, you know, the your observation is quite right, Ajay. I think, nowadays, you know, the sector rotation is happening in a full-fledged way. You know, wherever the pockets which are, you know, relatively low price to their earnings or low price to book value, you know, even they're also really performing quite well. If you recall the market rally about a year back, you know, only if you select high-quality, high-growth companies were performing well. But in the recent rally, I think, you know, value is also participating. Companies which are relatively priced, closer to the replacement cost, where, you know, whether it could be cement and, you know, commodities, etc., you know, they've also started performing quite well. And, broadly speaking, I think, you know, most sectors are participating in this rally. Even if any one or two pockets where they're not yet rallied, if the valuations are attractive, I think that will just get corrected, you know, very soon. And that's how the markets are today. Rally is quite broad based, and it's populated to the value segment as well now.
All right, Sampath, we'll let you go on that one. Thanks so much for joining us. Look forward to chatting more with you in the coming days. Let's shift focus.